I'm not usually the chairman of a sitting like this, but having finished this speech book with the Sakurashvili, can you hear me? I did invite Yitzchok by email, and he answered me with an email, a very beautiful email, which he's grateful for what he did. He doesn't know why he had the chus to do such a thing, to buy this building for us. It was very, very, very nice about it. I just want to repeat something about this building and the other building, 766 and 760, this building. I mentioned it before, but that first building was purchased for the library in 1965. What happened was, there used to be a dentist, Dr. Shapiro, who lived in 766, where the library, that first half of the library is. And he was moving, he spoke with Meshel Rothstein, one of the other's main secretaries for many years in Europe and in America. And he mentioned to him that he's planning to move to Manhattan with his wife, Rose, and with the children. He's retiring, and he wants to sell the house, and if they have any interest, he would like to know, and he wouldn't want to sell it to anybody else without asking us if we can use it. So they discussed the price. It was $35,000, which is, at that time, was a lot of money. I went to Rabbi Chorokov. I told him that we have this opportunity to buy the building right next to 770. Chalul should go to somebody else. And I need $35,000. And he said he doesn't have it. Go raise the money. I didn't know where to go. I was Mosquitos already for 9-10 years, but I wasn't. Anyways. So one time at dinner at home with my wife and children, I brought up the thing around this kitchen table with the family, and my wife, Alora Shalom, suggested to me, why don't you call up Jack Schwaben? He was a partner in the E.J. Corvette department store chain, all over the place, New York, Chicago, Philadelphia. And he was a good friend, and his wife was a tzaddikah. She was a very, very fine lady. And talk to him, maybe he can help us with the money. So I did that the next day, and sure enough, Marilyn, she says, yeah, come over tomorrow night at 7:30. And she didn't know what I was coming for. Well, the next night came, and we got there, and she lived in Great Neck, the fancy part of Great Neck.
King's Point.
And in the gorgeous mansion. And we sat down to talk, and I got to the point about the house, the building we would like to buy, we don't have money. Told him how much it was, and within 15 minutes, I got an answer sitting there that they'll pay for the whole cost of the building. And Marilyn said, before you close, give me a few days' notice. Meet me in the J.P. Morgan Bank, and let's call something else in the Northern Boulevard, where they live. And I'll get you all the money you need, and certified checks, not only for the cost of the building, but any whatever other expenses you make for the legal things and things like that. So that's how we got that building. And this building, we need this building too. We can't go any further, but I don't think that I've wanted anyone to go further than this building. This building was available when we got the Shapiro building, but there was some problem where the Rebbe said we shouldn't get it at that time. But now, of course, we got it ahead of it. But I don't think we can go further. But, you know, I've been rumbling lately about making a new, it's not for this, I shouldn't be saying this, but Kenzich Steinhalten. And I heard a lot of things from the Rebbe about building a new Merkez Chabad around 770. Merkez, a Lomi Merkozi. And one of the things we have in mind is to build a library. When we get there, we'll be able to do it. So this is only temporary. But it's beautiful. We need it. I want to thank Sean Bailey for his 40 years of service. They shall live and pay by the hour, you'd be a multi-millionaire. I'm not kidding. You walk by 770 at night, you drive by, look at the top floor to the left. Lights are on. 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. He's pushing the edit from them. You couldn't find a better person, but you couldn't have a better librarian. And I think the Rebbe has a lot of respect. For him and for what he does. Yossi Popak is a strange fellow. I call him incessantly for years. There's never been a thing that he turned me down and said no. I don't remember. Do you remember ever said no? No. Everything. More than I can remember, more than I can say. I knew your dad, Shmuel Isaac, Oliver Shalom. And I knew him from the early 40s, although I wasn't just still a kid before Bar Mitzvah in Boston. I came here in 46. When my father, Oliver Shalom, brought me to New York to send me to Camp Masifta. There wasn't Gan Yisrael then. Camp Masifta in Ferndale. And he was the one across the street. Apartment that was run by some secretaries of the yeshiva. And so I know from then, and I know him as I grew up, that everyone's put it close together by Ferengi. The Rebbe told me to say L'chaim, and then he said, Shumaz, Egit of the cars. Don't create. So we both, the Rebbe joined us together to say L'chaim, for whatever the Rebbe was referring to, very lovingly. And your mother, Miriam, is your mother's name? She used to be a gangster from Boston, the Sheikh Abad, decades. And as such, I spoke with her very, very often during the convention. So you come from a very, very good stock. I just want Yossi to know that I don't think I ever thanked him for anything. I took it for granted, and I was probably right. but look at this. It took a while, a lot of pain, and kolayz bebinyan. It's not simple. The Maharish taking Gemara does something. But he fit the bill just perfectly. And going forward, Amir Hashem, might bother you more. I've been asked to present something to you. This is a book. There's only a few left, maybe two or three copies available. Yeah. In the base, I can know them. It's Treasures from the Chabad Library. It's a magnificent book.